Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. In the previous video on observational learning, we saw that learning could occur without any direct reinforcement or punishment, that the children could learn about behavior simply by observing the adults. And this suggests that there's some sort of cognitive process going on while the children are observing, right? There's learning happening even though it's not being demonstrated yet. And so this brings us to this idea of latent learning. And this was researched by a guy named Edward Tolman. And so I want to look at two studies that Tolman conducted that demonstrate this cognitive process of learning. Now, the first study that we'll look at was conducted by Tolman and Charles Honzik. And what they did was they had three groups of rats. And they put these rats into a maze. And they ran the rats in this maze every day for 17 days. So what were the three groups of rats that they had? Well, the first group got a reward for getting to a certain point in the maze. So they had sort of an end goal to get to. The second group didn't get a reward. So as far as these rats were concerned, there was no end point to the maze. They just kind of wandered around in the maze, right? Because there was no point where they got a reward. And then the third group of rats was sort of a combination of these two. They didn't get a reward for the first 10 days, and then starting on the 11th day, they started getting a reward. So the third group has no reward for the first 10 days, and then they started getting the reward on the 11th day. Okay, so if we look at the behavior of these rats, what do we see? Well, here's the days. That they're performing in each maze, and then this is going to show the number of errors that they made. So how many wrong turns do they make in the maze before they get to this end point? Okay, well, let's look at the first group. So the first group of rats is getting a reward. So initially, they make lots of errors, but over time, they make fewer and fewer errors. They get better at doing the maze because they're being reinforced to get to this particular point, and so they learn. How about the second group? Well, the second group is not getting a reward. So they don't really know what the end of the maze is. They just kind of wander around, as I said. And so they're just going to be kind of wandering the whole time. Now, this follows this very sort of standard behaviorist explanation of how learning occurs, right? You get reinforced for something and you get better at it. You learn to change your behavior. And that's essentially what we see here. But the interesting part comes with the third group. So what happens with the third group? Well, just like the others, when they first are put in the maze, you know, they're just kind of wandering around. And just like the second group, right, they're just kind of wandering around. But then, after 10 days, they start learning. Now, you might think that they would sort of gradually decrease, just like the first group. But what Tolman and Honzik found was this group of rats suddenly started performing, by the end of the study, even better than the group that was rewarded all along. So what does this mean? Well, this demonstrates that this third group of rats, throughout this 10-day process here, they were actually learning. They just didn't have a reason to demonstrate that learning, right? But there was something going on that when suddenly you start putting a reward into the maze, they start getting to it very quickly. And that shows that they actually have been learning something about the maze all along. And so this is this idea of latent learning. And so latent learning refers to learning that occurs without reinforcement. So when the rats are just wandering around in this maze there with no reinforcement, they're actually still learning about the maze. The reason that, you know, early behaviorists wouldn't think that they were learning is that rats didn't have any reason to demonstrate that. And so by this idea, we could say the second group of rats here that got no reward, they're actually learning during those first 10 days too, but they never got the opportunity to show it. So the idea of latent learning is that learning occurs without reinforcement, but it's not demonstrated until there's a reason to do so. So, but just because the learning hasn't been demonstrated doesn't mean that it hasn't occurred. Now, we actually operate on this assumption all the time. When you think about when you sit in school, right? You sit in class, you sit for a lecture or something. We assume that you're learning something by sitting there, but there's no observable change in your behavior, right? We hope that the learning is occurring sort of latently, right? That you're sitting there, you actually are learning. You're just not going to demonstrate that learning until, you know, the test day arrives, or we give you some challenge and now you're able to show that you have actually learned something from sitting in that lecture. But when you first were learning it, there was no incentive to demonstrate it, right? And that's quite similar to the idea of these rats here, where they're learning about the maze, but they have no reason to show you. They're not going to need to rush to the end of the maze because there's no reward there. Then you start putting a reward there, and suddenly they demonstrate that they actually do know this maze pretty well. Okay, I want to look at one other study by Tolman, and this was conducted with Ritchie and Kalish as well in 1946. And what they did in this study was they had a very simple maze that they put some rats in. So the maze had an entry point into this sort of round room here, and then there was one exit, and then the corridor turned to the left, and then it turned to the right, and then it turned to the right again, and then at the end of this long hallway was the food reward. Right. And so they had rats complete this very simple maze. Right? They, you know, here's our rat here, he's gonna run in here, go straight through, turn left, turn right, and get to the food reward. Then, after the rats had learned this sort of layout of this maze, the researchers changed it a bit. What they did was, it's the same entrance, right? Same round room, but now, instead of just one corridor, there were many different corridors, branching off in all directions. And the sort of straight ahead version that the rat had previously been taught was now blocked. Right. So the question is, which of these hallways will the rat run down? And one of the ones angling off to the right here actually went out to the food. Right. So the food was actually in the same general location that it was before, but now the rat's going to have to choose a new route to get there. And there are actually more of these corridors than I've drawn here. Oop, I guess I put that in the wrong place. Anyway, I'll post a link to the original paper. You can see a diagram of what this actually looked like. This is a very rough approximation. Okay, so the question is, what would the rat do? Well, the traditional behaviorist explanation would be, okay, the rat runs in, tries to go straight, that doesn't work. Okay, so the idea is, well, maybe, I don't know, stimulus generalization will occur, something, the rat will choose the most similar behavior. Or they say, well, maybe the rat, the first turn that was reinforced was turning left, so maybe the rat will get here, can't go straight, it will turn left, it will try going this way. And that's not what happened. What they found in this study was the rat actually chose the correct corridor. And this showed the idea of a cognitive map. So what the cognitive map refers to is the idea that the rat actually has a notion about where the food is in relation to the starting point. The rat is not just learning, how do I get food, turn left, turn right, and then that's where food is. The rat is actually learning, okay, I'm here, and food is over there somewhere, and so I should try to get over there. And if I suddenly have a new path that goes that way, then that's the one that I should choose. Instead of thinking of behavior as simply being reinforced rote learning of turn left, turn right. So that's the idea of this cognitive map. And this shows that the rat must have some internal mental representation of the rat's location and the food's location in relation to the rat, right? And that's what this study demonstrates. It shows that it's not a strict behavioral process of this turning left or turning right was reinforced, but rather that the rat has actually learned about the layout of this maze here, and it knows where the food is. And this is true for humans as well. I mean, if you've ever gone to a restaurant, right? Let's say you're waiting for a table at a restaurant and you need to use the bathroom. And so you ask someone, excuse me, where's the bathroom? And they tell you, okay, go down this hallway, turn left, turn right, and then the bathroom is there. Well, now let's imagine later on in the evening, you're sitting at your table in a completely different part of the restaurant, and you need to use the bathroom again. Well, you don't follow those same instructions, right? You don't say, okay, how do I go to the bathroom? I turned left, I turned right, you know, because you know that's not going to work anymore. Instead, you've formed a cognitive map. You have an idea of where is the bathroom in relation to me? And this learning has occurred, again, sort of latently. You didn't have a reason to demonstrate this until later, but it shows that you do have this cognitive map. You have an overall understanding of location, not a specific reinforcement of the actual steps of the behavior. Okay, so I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.